This is Lois Maris with Keller Williams Premier Realty in Rochester, Minnesota, with the February 2011 Real Estate Market Report. In February of 2011, there were 221 new listings come available on the market. This compares to 282 listings a year ago in the month of February, which represents a 21% decrease in activity. This is okay for us. We have fewer buyers on the market right now for a variety of reasons, so a smaller inventory of homes is totally acceptable. There were 101 homes in February of 2011 which took new contracts versus 106 a year ago. That represents a 5% decrease, but that's actually a welcome number for us. In February of 2010, we had the federal tax stimulus program for real estate for the first-time home buyers receiving a tax credit if they purchased a home. This year, we don't have that stimulation in our real estate market, and so to be down only 5% is wonderful news. Couple that with the fact that sold homes are up. So we had 76 homes in the month of February actually closed a transaction versus 73 homes a year ago. That represents a 4% increase in sold activity, again, in a non-stimulated real estate market. That's very good news for us locally. The homes that did sell in February were on the market 151 days on average, compared to 142 days a year ago in that stimulated market. So this is up just slightly. We do have to stay on the market slightly longer in order to get a contract. The average sale price for a home in February of 2011 was $162,766,000. This is a 2.7% decrease in average sale price. These are mixed numbers that we're seeing. You have to be on the market longer and you're getting less for your home from a year ago. However, we have very healthy activity. So what's happening here is we're still seeing an impact of foreclosures and short sales bringing down our price. People are having to stay on the market longer and do more price reductions to get their home sold. Active listings in total, not just new listings for February, this includes residential homes, condos, and townhomes. In February, it's 1,228, which is just slightly down from a year ago. And here's the sold price to list price ratio. In order to sell your home, you took about 95% of your original list price. Your original list price a year ago, that was about 97%. So this is just another statistic that's showing us we have to reduce the price of your home in order to get that contract, and that's taking a little bit more days on market, and that's a result of continued short sale and foreclosure impact. Some other good news is what's selling here. If you look at this graph, the light blue bars are 2010 statistics versus the gray bars 2011 statistics. And we can see that last year that first-time home buyer range went up to really about $120,000 usually. That was much busier. This year, thankfully, it's actually in the move-up buyer range. This is the activity is coming in the $100,000 to $250,000 price range, which is very, very good. If you look at the chart down below, this is showing what's listed, and it's showing that this price range that has the most activity of buyers is actually the same price range that has the greatest activity of listings coming on the market. So that's a good match. However, we still have more listings than we have buyers. And the high-end price range still continues to be slow, but activity has picked up a little bit there. If you would like a full market report from us, you can contact us in a variety of ways. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, our webpage, davidandloismaris.com, and we also show home videos.